Sorry, I was distracted because they changed the stream manager layout on the iPad and it was confusing me. I didn't know what to do with it. GDG, I saw you were super early. Welcome on in. Hello, thanks for being here. Sister Scone, lovely to see you. Good morning. Hamlin's here. Very good morning to you as well. Still making breakfast. Very nice. Sister, please maybe have breakfast. Barnabas, Pengu's, lovely to see you. Anxious, welcome on in. And Demonarchy is here. Oh my gosh. Oh, he's not here. Never mind. We never saw him. So Canadian to start his stream with, sorry. GDG, thank you so much for the resub. For my 9-month anniversary. Oh, for my 9-month sub anniversary, I wish for a sword. And your wish was granted. Yeah. Thank you so much. Shadow, welcome on in. Good morning. Is it morning for everybody? Am I the only one living in afternoon time right now? I'm about to head to a circus thing, so I won't be around today. That's awesome! Is it Cirque du Soleil, or is it a different circus? I follow them on Instagram. I wanted to join the circus when I was in university. so I was kind of stalking them, thinking I could maybe get in as a band member. I also made an iced coffee in like 2 minutes while the timer was going down, so I'm very proud of that. Speed coffee. Mmm. GDG is in the afternoon time zone. Very good. You've seen a street lamp in a circus before? What is this? It's a local circus. School's event. Oh, lovely! Very nice. Support the small circus. Aren't you still in university? Yeah, I've been in a lot of universities. I mean, my university back in Canada, because I was in the middle of lamenting of like, what do I do with my life? Because I was a piano major and I realized that I didn't really have the chops to be a professional concert pianist. So then I was like, what do I do now? And then we saw a show in Vancouver from Cirque du Soleil. And I was like, oh my God, I want to be a band member. And then I was on that train for quite a while. So 3 universities ago. Yeah. Yeah, I did take a little bit. I took a year and a half of a writing and publishing course in my hometown because basically I just felt guilty about not doing post-secondary when I left high school, but I still wanted to get, I was working on my RCM grade 9 piano. So I wanted to go into music university, but I wasn't quite at the level yet. So I was like, I'll just do this on the side and be productive and did that as well. Now I can finally say like I'm over school. I'm over it. I thought oh Flavor, thank you very much for the follow. I thought I would really miss university when I was done, but like I think I've kind of outgrown it in some way. I don't know. I don't mean like outgrow in age. I just mean like outgrow in like that phase of my life, because I think obviously anyone can go to university at any age, and they can go back whenever they want. It's just yeah, I think I'm in a different place now. Giant Pixels, it's nice to see you. Yeah. Same with like leaving my hometown. When I first thought of leaving my hometown, I was like, no way, I really, really want to be here still. And there's so much that I want to do here. And then I got to a point in my life where I'm like, nah, I'm bored. I'm going to go. I'm going to head. I finally catch the entire stream since my chess lesson was moved. Oh my God, you're gonna be here all day. You're gonna be here all day with us. That's awesome. In university, I started together with someone on their fourth bachelor. Whoa, they already had over 10 years of university education but liked it so much. That's amazing. Ilaria, welcome on in. I think, like, I definitely think I'm never gonna stop learning. I think that's so important as a musician, is to keep doing what you do. Even, like, I was thinking of renewing my Score Club subscription, which is a really good composer that has, like, it's kind of like a Patreon for composers. So you, like, go in and it's, like, I think 60 hours worth of pre-recorded lessons, counterpoint for composers, how to arrange certain instruments and stuff. And I really, really like it. So I was like, even if, you know, like, when I'm done university and stuff, I'll probably renew my Score Club subscription and maybe do some Skillshare or something. Just keep the brain active. I don't think you need to be in university to keep learning stuff, but I definitely understand people who do. Especially nowadays, you can just like pick up any online university class and just go for it, you know? Oh, the Denny's as well. Woo. Sorry, I'm going to be looking like way over here today because I got my second monitor. You guys can be very proud of me, but it's not working. We're having a bit of a technical issue. Dag was helping me troubleshoot it while he was traveling, which is very kind of him. So right now I have the 24 inch over here, and I have my laptop here, and I have the iPad here. I just gotta figure out what's going on with it. Lamp hype, woo! Yes. There's much excellent training online aside from university content. Yeah, and like a lot of universities are making their classes just available to people. You know, there's a lot of classes I've heard you can take, and you don't get, obviously you don't get a degree or something at the end, but you can get like the credits sometimes. Or you can just enjoy the class as it is. Are we starting with all the originals today? Oh my god, we are. Oh my god. Oh my god. Yeah. I didn't tune my guitar yet, so hold on real quick. The weather is changing, all my batteries are low. That's better. Yeah. Oh. Nah. Really gotta fix that string. Where's my capo? Where'd I put it? I had it. Just there it is. Yo. Ah. It's behind my ear protection. You guys, get ear protection for concerts. I can't tell you enough how important it is if you're a regular concert goer. Who did what just now? Half Beep. Oh my gosh! Thank you so much for the resub. And it's lovely to see you. Happy Saturday. Da-da. Song spot is behaving, yes. And sorry, I missed a Kin Assassin. Hello, I did one online course and go to the credits. Very nice. Yeah, and there's so much flexibility nowadays when it comes to doing online classes. I sort of did a song spot for the chess community. What? That's amazing. How does that work? My ears are already ruined. Oh no, sister, no! Not like this! I never stopped resubbing. Happy. That's very kind of you. I feel like I haven't seen you in a while. I hope you've been well. Yeah, I wear these little sound protectors when I go out for concerts now, and it makes such a difference. Especially because when I'm doing studio sessions, you have to listen to the monitors quite, like, much louder than I would prefer to. No ear protection needed. Nah, Dag, you also need ear protection. Everyone needs ear protection. When I've been out at clubs and stuff, I've been seeing a lot of people wear their regular earbuds, in the club, and that's always a good thing. Also, I hope your train is going well. It has a couple of options. It can cue people to sign up to play chess against a streamer. Oh, that's interesting. I could post about it in Discord. Let me not take up the chat. You got it. Yes, show the love. I'm very curious. Anyone who could do any kind of programming is a magician to me. Someone will bite them off. Yeah. I don't remember there being a whole lot of ear biters going around. Just listening to better music. Can you imagine, Helen, you're at a concert and you're like, hold on. I'm just gonna put in some other mother right now. Oh, that's crazy. Twice is too many times for that to happen. What's happening? We're starting with Aviator? Yes, we are. I don't like... Is there a way to like get rid of the screen on the activity feed? It makes me unhappy. I just want the whole thing activity feed, and I don't want to see my stream at the same time. Get out of here. Oh, I can! Okay, good. That's better. That's better, more activity. Will you bring your guitar to TwitchCon? No. No, it's no way. Just the idea of like bringing the tailor on a plane and a bunch of trains would be tough. But I hear that there are going to be instruments there, so if I could yoink someone's guitar for an evening session or borrow the piano, that would be great. Visible to all. Oh, thank you. Yes. There we go. Thanks for letting I didn't understand what you said, but the answer is probably yes. Yeah, oh yeah, I figured it out, don't worry. When I first uploaded this while the timer was going down on the opening scene, they're like, oh, we've completely redone Stream Manager, and I'm like, no. Don't change anything, please. Yoinkin' instruments. Yeah, and Pitbull's in the chat, hello. All right, let me sing this song before the queue gets a crazy.
Spent your time on the dirt or on the ocean when the sea is fair. But the hull of your ship has always belonged in the air. And when they told you you can't, you never break pace. And while they're still running, you finish the race. A cleverer man I've never known. You're a trick and a laugh, a bit of a clown. In my aviator, just keeps flying. My aviator never comes down. Don't you know that you've left us behind on the ground?
Yeah, anxious. You just. Oh my goodness! Thank you so much for the 500 bits for a song bump. You got it, sir. Oh, it looks like it was. Wait. No, it's already here. Anxious, request another song so we can bump it, please. Thank you. I hope they'll let me in. What is usually you buy the TwitchCon tickets? Do they ever run out, or I assume that you can just get them closer to maybe, even though I already have it. Oh my gosh. I typoed my first name on the ticket. I hope they let me in. Oh no. Yeah, they do say, like, you have to have matching ID. Opened a request ticket, but only got an automated response. Oh no. Yeah, I'd say do what GDG suggests and just change your legal name. That could be a marketing trick. Yeah, I can imagine that it's probably a really big venue. It probably wouldn't get to capacity super quickly. The 1 day ticket sold out, but not the 2 day tickets. In Paris, neither sold out. Oh, okay. Yeah, that isn't. Get them while they're hot. Get the tickets while they're hot. Stay. Stay. get a reminder to buy a ticket, even though I got one already, I guess. What are you drinking? Oh, I'm in iced coffee with a little bit of maple syrup. It's just some instant coffee, water, some oat milk. Very good. I just needed a little bit of a pick-me-up later today because I had a late night last night. I was out at the club. Not really clubbing though. There were a bunch of live bands and I wanted to see them. I wanted to get some coffee. I already had an ice cream. What? Oh, you should have an affogato. Then you can get the best of both worlds. Whenever I'm like, I want ice cream, but I also want more energy to be caffeinated, then I just get an affogato. Paranoid, welcome on in. You put maple syrup in your coffee. That's the most Canadian thing ever. I do. Yeah, I do. I love maple syrup in my coffee, hot or cold. It is perfect. And when it's really cold, back in the ranch days, you just put a little bit of Fireball in the coffee, which is another Canadian thing. Iced coffee. Yeah, it is kind of cold coffee because there's only 3 ice cubes in there and they are gone. So it's mostly just not room temperature coffee. Anxious Twitch is not letting me give subs. What? Anxious, what the heck? What's going on with that? I need my coffee. Fireball in the coffee is tasty. Very good for cold days. When I used to go camping, I used to bring a little Mickey of Fireball because it was just so nice to have, especially like when it gets colder. Normally I went in the summer, so I didn't have that problem too much, but sometimes really early morning, I woke up with the sun when I was car camping, so I'd be up at like 4 or 5 a.m. depending on the weather, and just have just a little bit of that, and it's so nice. Ice cream macchiato counts as iced coffee. Yeah, it does. Yeah. Award, welcome on in. When I discovered that McDonald's sold affogato in Europe, I was like, oh man, it's over for me. This is it. I've never had maple syrup. Giant Pixels, you never had maple syrup? That's so sad. I know for Americans, they have like pancake syrup. It's not the same thing. It's not. It's just like a corn syrup that's dyed brown or something. You gotta get some like good, authentic maple syrup. That's the way to go. The stuff that I got is like, it tastes a little spliced in my opinion. It's just, it was on sale at the store. But my mom will sometimes bring me the little tins of the really authentic stuff. So nice. Fireball and apple cider. Oh, heck yeah. We used to make apple cinnamon jello shots with Fireball as well, because you just get that cinnamon whiskey with a little bit of apple. Primo. Maple syrup isn't a thing in Europe. Yeah, it's very not. It surprised me. I'm like, no, my maple syrup, how will I survive? Can you buy it over here? It's not very cheap. And I think it's kind of, you know, like honey, sometimes they doctor honey and they put syrup with it and that kind of thing. So it's hard to get like really authentic maple syrup, but yeah, the US probably has both. Yeah, because you're so close to Canada and under Quebec maple syrup stocks. It's more expensive. Yeah, I know they have some at, whenever I see like authentic Canadian maple syrup here, it's really expensive. Yeah, it's not that hard to produce, I don't think. It's just an art to it that the Europeans haven't decided to do. Yeah, what else do I put maple syrup? I put maple syrup in everything. Ah, it's so good. On ice cream? You put a little bit of maple syrup on ice cream? Oh, man. The correct tree is over here. Oh, that's probably why. I don't know, back home, like, you didn't just have maple syrup, you'd also have, like, the seasonal syrups, so depending on when you tap the tree at what time of the year, you're gonna get a different color and a different flavor profile of the maple syrup, so it's kind of like beer, you know, you can have a lager, or you can have a stout, depending on how it's done. Same thing with maple syrup. Many maple trees in Europe. Oh, we gotta bring some maple trees over to Europe. I tried it. It's just extremely sweet. It is, yeah. It also makes it really good. I like using it as a sugar substitute because I'm not really fond of using just straight sugar. I'd rather use honey, or I'd rather use maple syrup. And you can use a little less of it because it's so sweet. Living in Boston, I'm spoiled with easy access to real maple syrup. Me too, right? I didn't realize until I left Canada. I'm like, oh, it's not so plentiful over here. I'm used to just always having it in the household. Different tree syrups, but they're not so sweet. That sounds awesome. I'd love to try some different tree syrups. I live down south. Oh, I'm sorry, sister. Yeah, could I smuggle in maple trees? Will that get me in trouble? That would be the most Canadian reason to get arrested, is just trying to illegally bring maple syrup into the country. We're doing Denny's. We're doing Denny's! There's too many buttons now, and I don't know which ones to hit. And Giant will be able to see it. Yay! Hold on, let me get these cables out of here. Hit all the buttons. If I hit all the buttons, I think the stream will go away. I don't want to do that. But I'll wait now. Oh, okay, well, let me sing it for you real quick so you can get your coffee.
I saw you at the library, your face in a book, serious and sweet with that dreamer's look, and it took everything I had to ask your name. Well, you gave me a grin and it made my heart spin, and I knew just then what to do. Well, I think you're great and super cute, which is why I have to fight you. We'll meet at dawn, we'll need car headlights on to illuminate the arena where we'll duel. I know a great spot, the Denny's parking lot. The employees like to bet, sometimes it's true. I think I'll earn a milkshake, yeah, once I'm done fighting you. I'll dress like a flirt, boots and a skirt, with my cutest set of antler throwing knives. You're looking so sweet in those jeans and that tee. I kind of hope you make it out alive, but that's not the point. The point is, and I further digress, I just don't know what to do with the rest. So I'll stick with what I stick with best and find you. You're confused, but stay the course. We pass some shiners back and forth as you yell that you thought we'd go for coffee. But I never got anywhere with anyone good, settling for dinner or movies like I should. Though I'll admit, when I said Denny's, you may have misunderstood. But put them up and fight me. I pulled out some brass, but these are my rules, Jerry. Okay, can this ass. My knuckles ain't what they used to be since I broke some cowboy's ass. You can teach a bloke to fish, but you can't teach him class. But you're doing rather well, in fact better than they could. Maybe it's just that crowbar that's making you look good. Lamp, stop reading the chat. I swear it's not a blush, it's just the blood stain on my face. My uppercuts aren't great, but yours are a disgrace. And I know it's not what you hear on a first date, but fight me. Well, we've been going for about an hour with this joust. If you want to tap out, we get waffles on the house. You find me an ice pack, I'll bandage your arm. I think the tears in your clothes really add to the charm. And next week, if you find that you're free, maybe we could just go out for ice cream. I know a cool joint where I hang with my friends, and we can fight them.
Sorry, I just looked up and saw GDG say the piano playing is so good, and then I was like, what chord was I on? This completely derailed me. I gotta not read the chat, but you guys were such fun emotes and stuff. Royal, welcome on in. So tricky. We'll fight your concentration until it breaks. Fair. You guys won. Joey, lovely to see you. That is a meticulously ironed blouse, is it? I haven't ironed this thing at all. I got it from the thrift store last week. Turns out fear monitors did have an advantage. Yeah, as soon as I'm like not reading sheet music, I don't know what to do with my eyes. Like, I just don't know where to look. And so I just go to what's like popping up, which is the chat. And I'm like, don't read the chat. We'll try to see. Fighting for an hour is impressive. Yeah. Hey, good round. Happy to help. My teacher used to like my piano teacher back home, he used to compliment me while I was playing, right? I'd be like doing a thing and he'd be like, good job with the bar. And then I'd hear the compliment and I'd be like, yes, I'm doing a thing. And then I'd wreck everything. So you had to like save what I did well until the end of the piece. Because if I see a compliment and then I like overthink about my playing and I'm like, I'm doing well. Oh, I better not mess up now. It's such a weird mental thing. Bye, Giant. Wait, is Giant leaving? No, Dag's leaving. Oh, he's going on lurk. Heck yeah. Giant's gonna make a coffee. Stare awkwardly at the camera without blinking. Oh my god. Direct eye contact with the people. Furry, welcome on in. Yeah, goofy times. I was also gonna say something. What was I gonna say? Oh, something about the production stuff. I don't know. Grab a coffee break before the next song starts. Yay! When criticism messes you up, not compliments. Yeah. I know, but I'm criticizing myself constantly in my head. I got the revised music videos and I went through them, and the guy did a really good job because some of the things were like, okay, this looks fine, but I look terrified. So could we like zoom out a bit? So because I was like at first thing in the morning, brand new studio, I was trying to get it all in one take and I just like have dead eyes a couple of times in the shot because I'm focusing so hard on trying to get the take right that I forget that there's a whole bunch of cameras on me. So I was like, could we just change the angle or like switch to the guitar shot so that they can't see the fear in my eyes. Start talking about video games, I have a bit of time. Oh yeah, we're playing Lethal Company tonight? I wanna play Lethal Company tonight. What's this drink? It's iced coffee. Yeah. Tonight works with time. I'll probably end stream 3, 4, 5, around 6-ish. And then if you guys give me an hour or so to have dinner, then I'll be online. So 7, 8, if that works. I don't know where Charlie is, but I know she's in a pretty rough time zone. I look mean when I'm focused. I can scare people just by thinking. I don't have resting bitch face, but I have like resting sad face. Like people could be like, I'll just be thinking about stuff. People be like, what's wrong? I'm like, nothing. I'm using my brain and my default face is looking upset. So that happens, especially when I'm doing like classical music and piano. Like I'm so focused in on what I'm trying to do, you know? Charlie should be asleep at that time, time zone wise. Oh no. I think Laszlo might join us. That'll be like morning her time. He had coffee from Mason jar in the bingo car. I love it. I have so many of these. These are yogurt jars. And every time I get some yogurt, I'm like, oh, free jar. That's amazing. I don't have Tupperware. I just have jars. I put everything in jars. Because they're free and you get lots of them. So you get for using your brain. I know. I know. And like, I don't know if you guys would really catch it, but I know like, I know how my face works and like, and my mom, she'd be able to see it immediately. She'd be like, oh wow, you got those dead eyes because you're just overthinking, you know? I even did a take of the chops where I did a good take and then I was like wincing so hard at the end because I messed up and the producer was like, it was a good take, but don't make that face at the end. I'm like, oh, I forgot there were cameras. I'm just like so focused on the sound, you know? No, you pay for them when you buy yogurt. GDD. Also, I always call you GDG, but I should just call you Dex because it's just my habit of reading the first part of the username. I'm afraid if I try to smile when in thought, I would look like a villain. Oh no, dead eyes, big smile. Yeah. And then I feel like I'm being expressive, and I look back on the videos, I'm like, I'm not really, I feel like I'm making a big expression, and I'm not. My wife steals ramekins from restaurants. We have dozens. That's awesome. Gotta take what you can get. I respond to both by now, but people mostly call me Dex. Okay. Deal. You are now Dex. Yes. Yeah. I did another session of the new Midas with the studio last week. Was it Friday? No, it was Thursday, I think, that we did it. God, the week has just flown by. And he had such a hard time miking my voice. It was so weird, because there was a second chorus that I sang quite weak. And I was like, I'd like to redo it. And he had to go through three different microphones because I kept clipping them all. It was so odd. I don't have that problem a whole lot, mind you, but the gain is like really far down on this microphone, so. Too powerful. Au contraire. I don't know if it's too loud. I have like a bit of a church voice. Like, it's good for cathedrals and churches because you can kind of like, it has like a, I don't know how to say it, like a clarity, I guess. So it's like the ticket for clipping microphones. I don't even have to sing that loud. If I sing like classical stuff, it just sounds atrocious on an audio file. Which is why, like, I try to sing differently when I'm mic'd, or I try to lean back more. I try to use more of my chest voice, because, yeah. He's like, you have an interesting voice. I'm like, oh, no. And he just had me, like, singing the chorus for probably, like, 15 minutes on and off. And he just, like, go in and try to adjust and, like, cut different frequencies to see if it would stop the clipping. It was brutal. I have a public restroom voice. What does that mean? Your public restrooms have really good acoustics, though. Not a lot of variation in frequencies. I don't know. It doesn't have that. I mind you, like, the music video stuff that I'm doing, there is one section in the chops where I notice you can kind of hear a bit of struggling with him trying to stop the clipping. Otherwise, it wasn't that big of a deal. But I mean, like, Denny's, Aviator, none of that stuff kind of clips the mic. For some reason, it's just the chorus on Midas. The way it goes up in arpeggio is not good. Oh, we're changing the light color to spicy. What do we change the light color to? We're doing the chops, are we? We're doing the chops, so we need to do something like... Also, sorry, that was 50,000. It was supposed to be 5,000, so I changed it. Do you have a color you want? How many hertz do you have? One hertz. Yeah. Oh, hold on. I gotta connect my phone to the light. What colors do you have? I have all of them, I think. I think they give you like a whole color dial. I know, it was cheesy. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. I don't know why it's, oh, there we go. What color is your aura? Orange. I've been told it is orange. I did that thing in White Rock where you go and you, like, put your hand on the little magnet thing and then they take a picture of you and then it shows your aura and then you print out, like, 10-page document what your aura is. And mine is orange. Pick a random one? Okay. This might get very bright also. I'm sorry in advance. I gotta like preset a bunch of different colors and then that'll be easier to switch through. This one, yeah, whoa. Got green. We got all kinds of things on the driver's seat. Do we get to see the lights with this much sunlight? That's a good question. It is very much visible. So we got green. We got red. Ah, no, I hate that one. That one's awful. That one's hard on my eyes. We could do blue, I guess. Yeah, the green, probably not the best. Don't want to look very, very jaundiced. I have no idea how this works, but the green tint is nice. We need the green tint. Big block or small block Chevy engine? The red is awful. Do you have teal? Ooh, I don't have teal. Oh! Okay, now I have the color wheel. Hold on. Da, 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 da. Yellow. It's kind of hard to see though with the light just outside. Purple. Heck yeah. Wait, teal. I love teal. Like this? Like that? Like teal. Red lights without skin flaws is why strip clubs use them, I hear. What? Really? Red lights? Is that why it's the red light district? All the colors don't make you look healthy. I know, yeah, it goes directly onto my skin. It's not like, oh, now the studio is blue. It's like, now lamp is blue. I apparently did not think this through very well. Oh, okay, we're staying away from the red. It's really grody. You can tell I've been listening to Valley Girl by Frank Zappa because I use the word grody. She's blue, da ba dee ba da, da ba dee da ba da. The contrast removes from the image, you look more like a ghost. Oh, for the teal. Yeah, I look like I'm kind of in black and white or something. Like, oh. Things that are not thought through, you should more fun to watch. Okay, good. Good, because I didn't think any of this through. And none of this is mod approved, so we're just going for it. All right, we'll stick with like this teal color or so. I was thinking change the light for like a song or something, because then you get the good, what am I doing? Oh, I'm bringing it all up front. Excuse me, sir. His posture is really good today, eh? I don't know what happened. Last stream he was really slouching, and today he's fine. He's just having a slow day, you know? Having a tired day. Is Earl blue now? Yes, Earl is blue now. Least street cringe. If you go too far, I'll just time you out. Okay. Wait, you'll time me out? Okay. Deal. The stream just stops for like 5 minutes. Yeah, he's having a good day today. We're doing the chops. Oh, and sister said a compliment. Oh my gosh, well, I'll take a compliment for me. Thank you very much. But this is actually a compliment to you. Thank you for being a fantastic part of our community. It is always so, so, so lovely to have you here. And you're hilarious. And you have fantastic hair energy. Use something different than your hair. Looks really good today. I had to redeem change color myself to make Lampy look healthy again. Everyone's gonna be fighting the lights. Hold on, what if I do more blue this way? Oh, that's so weird. Now that song's stuck in my head. How dare you? The green doesn't look green though. The green looks like just like a weird off color. Next stream, have apple juice in a gravy boat. I just thought of like apple juice and gravy together. That's nasty. Robert Christopher, thank you very much for the follow. Violet Beauregard. I know, that's what I think too, with the Gene Wilder movie, where they just like, just put a purple light on her face. Oh, that's orange. Okay, hold on. Ugh. There's no flattering way to go about this. I'm gonna look like a goofball no matter what I do. That's like more orange. I look a little jaundiced. Better if you change the color of the light in the background, keep yourself in white light. But doing this is way more fun for stream. I know. I know, like that's my main light. There's nothing behind me that I can change. I could get like the strip lights. Like, you know those like neon strip lights? And put them, I could put them like on the bottom of the closet. Cause if I put them higher up, I'm not gonna be able to open my doors, which sucks. But I could put them like underneath this way and then you guys could change those ones. Does it have strobe mode? Yeah, it does, but it's like really aggressive. So if anyone has is prone to seizures, I don't want to use it just in case. Yeah, it's got some special effects. It has like a fire flicker thing that I put on sometimes if I want like some ambient flickering lights. Need to open those doors. Yeah, my whole life is like in these closet space, like closet, like clothes, makeup, extra wires and stuff in this one, and cables and stuff that I need to put on Wilhaben that I have still not gotten around to. Extra suitcases for when I moved in here, and then more clothes probably like over this way. Yeah. Annette, welcome on in. You need to open those doors. Yes. All right, we'll have 10 shelves of makeup. No, it's like, I don't know how to describe it. They're like half hangers. Well, it's not true. These ones are hangers. And then these ones are like 3 different shelves. Where I have a lot of suitcases. I could probably finally get rid of those suitcases because I have had them for a very long time. Go for miles out of frame. Yeah, yeah. My whole apartment is just these shelves. There's a streamer that has one of the doors ajar, so viewers will strain to see what's in it, which is for fun. I feel like that's kind of the way with this mirror because you guys can see my desk, but it really is just like books. And my aloe vera plant, which is very happy right now. All my plants are very happy right now. It makes me happy when my plants are happy. I spot a plant. Yeah, it's my big aloe vera plant, which is crazy. There's actually 3 of them right now. Plus 1 for plant. Yes, and I'm pirating some mint. If you see over, oh, I don't know if you guys can see my window over there. No, you can't. I have some mint on the shelf that I got at the grocery store, and I'm like, I'm gonna make more of these, so I'm propagating them. I have an aloe vera plant too. It's becoming too big for its pot. Yeah, mine is like crazy. I had been neglecting it for quite some time, and eventually I was like, you know what, you deserve a new pot. And then it was like, I am going to make 7 more of me, and I'm good to triple in size. I have like a really nice leaf from it, and I don't know what to do with it. I could eat it, I guess. I got some audio issues with my sound system. Going to clean the connectors. Ah, oh, that sucks. Sounds good. Oh, Shiva, welcome on in. Can you eat them? Yeah, you can eat it. You can eat aloe vera. It's like aloe vera drinks and stuff. Are you supposed to put it on your skin or something? Yeah, you're supposed to. Apparently it's very good for cuts and like burns and stuff like that. But by the time I was to get a paper cut, the aloe vera probably would have spoiled by now. It doesn't la- I don't know how to make it shelf stable. So you could put like a cream on it or something. It's really slimy though, so I wouldn't want to like use it like a lotion because it's like meh. But as a kid, I used to like put it on cuts and things. It's the weekend. Clean your connector. Yeah, clean. I was doing some cable management today before the stream. Drinks, dinner, decoration, car fuel. Yeah, the amount of uses for aloe vera is just like endless. Same with dandelion. I'm growing some dandelion. I stole some dandelion seeds from the park, and hopefully they will sprout, and then I will have mint and dandelions. That'll make me really happy. All right, we're doing the chops. You guys thought talking about video games was bad. You got me talking about plants. Now we'll never get anywhere. Yeah, stealing seeds.
The table listening to your tales as I chew, as you convince me of your grandeur, all the things that you own and do. But I've seen your kind before, logical and self-assured. It's a mask that's not worth knowing, 'cause I know that you ain't got the chops, 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 chops. Yeah, you think you're good enough. You've got nothing to learn and money to burn. You'll have it your way. which is the only way that's right, 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 right. Oh, you always sacrifice to the lessers like me, who pretend we can't see that you ain't got the chops. Up on your shelf, you only start games you can win, always looking for that pin to pull on someone you should have known better. But I know that you ain't got the chops, 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 chops. No, you think you're good enough. You've got nothing to the only way that's right, 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 right. Oh, you always sacrifice to the lessers like me, who pretend we can't see that you ain't got the chops. You cut your losses on the stocks of the people you have bought, 'cause God forbid you're left away what you owe. 'Cause you ain't got the chops, 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 chops. No, you think you're good enough. You got nothing to learn and money to burn. You'll have it your way, all the way, every day, 'cause it's the only way that's right. You always sacrifice pretend we can't see that you ain't got the chops.
And we did it with Earl on our lap the whole time. Albertine, I was preparing for a live that was supposed to happen in 9 minutes. You mean me? I'm the live you should be watching. What else are you watching? My two favorite songs right at the start. Yay! Here's your crowbar back, mister. Aw, now he's kind of sad again. Yeah, you ain't got the schnapps, schnapps, schnapps. You think beer is enough. He said he had to leave. I didn't think I was going to be able to play that riff with him on there. But we did it. In schedule, it's saying that you're going live in 7 minutes now, so you're early. What? In which schedule? In the Discord or on Twitch? Man, I've been trying to keep up with my schedules. Like, to make sure that everything is showing the right time. Schedule. Saturdays, 3 p.m. What the heck are you looking at? A schnapps for tonight? Daylight saving shenanigans. Oh, yeah, maybe. Oh, we have another color change. What do you want, Albertine? We've discovered that the red looks really bad, so maybe not that one. I do kind of like the purple. It's kind of cool. Discord schedule says 53 minutes ago for me. Yeah, that tracks. Peach schnapps, Jägermeister, and cranberry juice. Oh man, Jägermeister is ugh. But I've mostly only had it with Red Bull, which is gnarly. Cedric, woke up in time for another lampy stream. Yes, lovely to have you here. But it's a date in February. What is that? What? It changed a date in April. It should be fine again. Oh, maybe it's a time hammer thing. Maybe I've got to change it around. Bye, Shiva. Thanks for hanging out with us. Have a wonderful Saturday. An hour. hour behind compared to now. Oh, I see. We're doing a doubt. Someone like you. It's a hot drink in the 90s. I know how to make that drink, Joey. I don't know. I do know how to make that. It was part of my bartending course. I don't know if I remember it now, actually, but we used to have like a full binder full of shots with really crazy, crazy names. Any cool ones. I know, like with the cocktail shaker, I used to pop the seal with your elbow. That was really fun. So you'd be like, chicka, 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 chicka. And then you could pour it that way, or like crack the egg. So instead of using the strainer on one side of the shaker, you just like do this, like you're cracking an egg, and then you can hold the ice and pour the drink at the same time. My bartending trick was getting you so hammered to give me all your money. No. We used to have like, you like my sound effects? Thank you. took a bartending course and you'll have your pick up in the, but it's something to do. I was working irrigation at the time. How old was I? I don't remember. I had just left high school and I was working summers at the ranch, and then 2 times a week, I would drive to the city and do my evening bartender course. And it was like where they'd set it up with colored water. And you'd see how many shots you could pour in a certain amount of time. It was mostly for like bartending events, that kind of thing. You know, like weddings and caterers and stuff where you just like need to go there and just pour a bunch of crazy shots for people. So not really stuff that I ended up using when I became a bartender. Mostly just being able to pour beer. But it was really fun. So maybe not, yeah. Yeah, and it gave me a real appreciation for mocktails, because there's so many times where I'm like, I want to make a fun, fancy drink, but I don't want to be drunk, you know, it's just Wednesday, and I just want to have something with cranberries in it, or orange, so I'll just make a mocktail. It's very nice. What was I going to say about the bartending course? Ah, frick. I don't know, my brain cells are leaving me today. So many crazy, crazy things. And Albertine has also done the mute piano. How dare you? I heard that you're... That means we turn the piano down here, I take off my headphones, and we see if I stay in key. Grandma Renee, Peach, and OJ. Oh my god, I just love Grandma Renee. Ready?
Sometimes it lasts in love. the blue, uninvited, but I couldn't stay away. I couldn't fight it. I'd hope you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg. I remember you said sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead.
I hope that was the right chord. Anxious, thank you so much for gifting a sub to Mom Omash. Mama Mima Marina. Yes, it is only muted for me, so let's hope I stayed on key. What I end on. It was. Hey! Very nice. We did it. I'm always worried that I'm just going to start sliding a half semitone down and you guys are going to be like, wow, this is atrocious. thank you kindly. Yes, what I do is I take off my headphones and I turn the piano down here because when I'm streaming, I actually want to hear the piano out instead of through the monitoring. It's a little easier for me. So just cut all of that. It's very unnerving. Not being able to hear anything.
I got come on.
Are follows free today? You know what? It's so weird you say that because they are in fact free today. But just today though.
We have Kokomo. Da 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 da.
I haven't done this song in a second.
Da 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 da. Steel drum band. Aruba, Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take you to Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama, Key Largo, Montego, baby, why don't we go Jamaica off the Florida Keys? There's a place called Kokomo, that's where you wanna go to get away from it all. Bodies in the sand, tropical drink melting in your hand. We'll be falling in love to the rhythm of a steel drum band down in Kokomo. Ooh, I wanna take you to Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama, Key Largo, Montego. Ooh, I wanna take it down to Kokomo. We'll get there fast and then we'll take it slow. That's where we wanna go, way down in Kokomo. We'll put out to sea and we'll forget our chemistry. By and by we'll defy a little bit of gravity. Afternoon delights, cocktails and moonlit nights. That dreamy look in your eye giving me an island high. Way down in Kokomo, Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take you to Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama, Key Largo, Montego, ooh, I wanna take it down to Kokomo. We'll get there fast and then we'll take it slow. That's That's where we wanna go. Way down in Kokomo. Way down in Kokomo.
Scoopy. I gotta revise that song because I don't agree with the G minor on there as well. Which keys are the Florida keys? F sharp or B minor? Oh, B minor, definitely. Pitbull, thank you so much for the 25 bits! Thank you kindly! Key of the people. Kokomo. Lion, thank you so much for the donation! Lion of Judah, if there's anything, we can play for you. Feel free to check out the song list, and we'll bump you. Da, 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 da. Thank you very much. And we have, oh my gosh, we have Black Horse and a Cherry Tree. I gotta prep my brain for this song. Pitbull, thank you for another 25 bits. Pitbull, please also pick a song. There are many songs to go around. What was I gonna say? Oh, dang it, I had it and I lost it. Oh yeah, so when I was at the club last night, and the producer was playing that I'm working with, he's playing bass for a band, which is why I went there. And so I got to meet, you know, these are the band members, and they're really lovely. And it's so wild to me, like, no matter where I go, whether it's university or a mixer or a co-working place or just out and about, as soon as people hear that I live stream, they're like, what? it's a super unique thing that I do, which I didn't think was that unique, but when you know, it comes up, people will have like so many questions, and I'm like, yeah, you know, there's like 300 or so songs that people can pick from, and we just, you know, it's kind of like, people say, they're like, oh, you're like a jukebox, you're like an in-person jukebox. I'm like, yeah, yeah, pretty much. Asian Invasion, thank you very much for the follow. Mr. Worldwide, ooh. Oh, that's the song I was thinking of. I was thinking of a Jason Mraz song. Mr. Wordplay, that's what it was. Say I'm all about the wordplay. Was on Instagram sounded nice. Yeah, except I messed up the video because I didn't want to add the first one because there was like a mistake with the sound, like in the guitar or something, so we had to stop and restart. But when I already posted it, I was like, it's already posted now, and I meant to put it on my story. This is a mess. So now I just have it on my reels instead. Yeah, they're really cool. They have a really neat sound. They're really lovely guys. And apparently, they're like a walking distance. They have their own studio, a walking distance from the studio that I'm working with right now. So they're like, if you want to come in for a writing session and you know, see how we do stuff, you're more than welcome. I'm like, oh my god, yes! So maybe I'll just go in and take notes and see. The only jukebox, yes. We throw nickels in Laffy, she starts playing songs. Yes, just like, I feel like, what do you call it? Steam Power Giraffe? Like the little like animatronic thing. Welcome on in, Zepsy. Happy Saturday, my dear. He hates it here. I hate it here. Oh, I don't have the Cult of Dionysus, but I should. Hold on. Albertine showed me an Orion Experience song, but I was like, I actually know that song because I gosh darn love the Orion Experience. They did a cover with Mother Mother for their song Wrecking Ball. Really, really good. Probably like, yesterday I heard you say you're lost. Oh, wait, hold on. It takes way up. Yesterday I heard you say your lust for life has gone away. It got me thinking, I think I know a similar way, and that's sad. Their stuff is so low. Let's make a decision, start a new religion. Yeah, we're gonna build a temple to our love. Orgiastic dances, nymphs and trances. Yeah, we'll be the envy of the gods above. Such a weird song to play. You're feeling devious, you're looking glamorous. Let's get mischievous. Probably do their Wrecking Ball one. I just don't know about this one. Pipple, thank you so much for the resub. Thank you kindly. Lamp's choice? Oh yeah, I have the power. I'll just leave you with the things when I'm late. Yay! I appreciate the trust. You've not done anything yet to void the trust. Therefore, you get 110% trust. I'm trying to think of what the other song was that I know from them. Oh, Digital Affection's really good. Got your digital affection. Obsessed with you. That one's on my workout playlist.
Got your picture on my wall. I dream about you when I sleep.
It's interesting how easy the chords are. Like, I'm like, oh, it's only B minor, G, and D. But when I hear the song, the way they arrange the instrumentals sounds so much more colorful and intense. Make it sing all ancient Greek mythology. You will get there. Yeah, my workout playlist is mostly like mother and stuff. I've been working out this week so I can take people in more Denny's fist fights. That's what Dag did to me. He just suddenly didn't show up one day. Yeah, we needed a mod and we're like, quick, Sebsi! Sebsi, hold this. And we just handed him a mod sword and now here he is.
Black horse in a cherry tree.
Yeah, and then we put him, yeah, we pulled him out of whatever basement he was in prior, and then we put him in our basement. And, gotta say, it was a pro move. Pro gamer move right there.
I think I want to play this on Capo, or on Capo 2.
I don't make the schedule. Just kidding, I do make the schedule. How did this happen? I dodged Egg modding me like a pro. Yeah, that's true. You earn our hit list, Pangoose, for a little while. You just like matrixed away the bullets. I can totally be trusted with mod powers. Don't tempt me, Albertine. I will make you a mod. Fingernails are a little long.
Well, my heart knows me better than I know myself, so I'm gonna let it do all the talking. I came across a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree.
I can't play that chord today.
When the big black horse felt a little fear upon my back, I said, don't look back, just keep on walking. When the big black horse said, look this way, he said, hey there, baby, will you marry me? But I said, no, 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 no. I said, no, no, you're not the one for me. No. I said, no, no, you're not the one for me. Ooh. And my heart hit a problem in the early hours and stopped it dead for a beat or two. So I sent it back to a place, I sent it back, oh no. So I sent it to a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. I won't come back cause it's all so happy and now I got a hole for the world to see, yeah. And it said no, 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 no. It said no, no, you're not the one for me. No, 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 no. It said no, no, you're not the one for me. No, 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 you're not the one for me. No, 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 no. the one for me. Big black horse in a cherry tree. I can't quite get that cause my heart's forsaken me. Big black horse in a cherry tree. I can't quite get there cause my heart's forsaken me.
Don't know why I couldn't get all those words in on the verse, so silly.
Tesno Pesno, I don't know if I said hello to you today. Well, come on in, happy Saturday.
Do not mod me, Lamp. I will ban Charlie just for breathing near me. If you ban Charlie, how are we going to get her to help us on Lethal Company, okay? You're burning bridges that we need, my dear. Also, can you guys help me out on how to install the More Company? Because I think we might be more than four people this week. Charlie, welcome on in! Yes, we were just talking about the devil and there they are. Are you playing Lethal Company with us at some really insane time tonight for you? So I can help you? Yay! Yay! I hope my friends can make it. Maybe Cass will make it too. That'd be really fun. Charlie does break down bridges that we need. One of my favorite sayings is, we'll burn that bridge when we get to it. Which is, there's a name for it. Where you take two sayings and you put them together to make a new saying. Half Beep, thank you for the 1,000 bits. Oh my gosh. Thank you, that was rad. A pleasure. That's one of my favorite songs to play. And I do believe I'm going to be playing it next week at the restaurant because it sounds really fun with the cajon player. Like when we get going into the percussive stuff. Oh, it's super fun. Thank you so much. I called Charlie on Discord so I can talk shit in front of her, not behind her back. Oh, that's lovely. I love the honesty, the transparency. It's so important here in the community. The best eclectic songs. Yippa-doo. The first time I heard that song, it was on a burned CD. And I was like, oh, this is new and exciting. Heck yeah, I request those songs. Let's burn that bridge after I cross it. Yeah, it's like, we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. So we'll deal with it when we get there and then burn a bridge. But it's like, we'll mess it up when we get there. Don't worry. We'll mess the bridge up once we get there. Like, it's really kind of hilarious. I only know the Dutch word for it. Contaminate? I requested too many songs. Giant, tell us what you would like to hear and we'll get it on there for you. It's not Spoonerism. Spoonerism is something else. Yeah. I also found out the rest of the saying, to the customer is always right. Apparently the full saying of that is the customer is always right in matters of taste, which means that they can buy something ugly, but doesn't mean that they get to treat you like garbage. I wanted to request Build That Wall. It seemed probably the Burning Bridges. Oh yeah, we could put that on. I haven't done that song in a while. I love that song. Ba, 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 ba. Yes. Let's do it. And thank you kindly. We are doing... What are we doing? We're doing Joni Mitchell? Doing some Joni Mitchell. Oh, my homework for this week is to transcribe Fields of Dust from the Star Wars Republic game. It's fun. I don't know why that reminded me of it. Oh, because I like video game songs and stuff. Maidenless, welcome on in. You guys realize that in 6 more years, today will be referred to as 20s instead of 1920s? Oh no. I feel so old. I make the leashy for Aviator? Absolutely not. Why would I ever do that? I'm gonna put out the Midas lead sheet ahead of time. Actually, I did bring Midas to my live jazz ensemble on Monday, and they did a really good job. I was like, look, I don't have a lot. I have like a really rough lead sheet and a demo, but could you guys make some magic happen? And they did. And I got some good ideas for the drums and stuff. Fazbear fan, lovely to see you. And that was really dang cool. But then he's like, could you actually like write a little bit more? I'm like, yeah. So I do have like a sheet music score going on that song so that they can read it better. for a year or two, right? Not considerate, maybe, possibly.
Rose and flows.
Oh, that's really low. Ha! Up here. What was I doing way down there?
Rose and flows of angel hair and ice cream castles in the air and feathered canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds' illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way you feel as every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go, and if you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusions I recall. I really don't know love at all. Tears and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud, and dreams and schemes and circus crowds. I've looked at life that way, but now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed, but something's lost and something's gained in living every day. I've looked at life from both sides now, from win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life at all.
Such a fun song to sing. Wish my eyes could move both sides now. That would be really weird. You know how chameleons can move their eyes individually? But why? To see all the monitors? California Dreamin's in the chat. Hello. I love the comedic bit where the eyes blink slowly, separately. You're like telling something really important to your dog and they're like, blink. Da, 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 da. Doing House of the Rising Sun. This one is so popular for the live shows on the at the restaurants and stuff. Which word just gotten out in my choir that I do gigs. And now they're like, oh, we should come by and watch you. I'm like, I don't know why it makes me so nervous when it's people that I know watching. I'm more comfortable with like a bunch of strangers just popping in and having dinner. But if it's people I know, that I'm like, oh no. So when I saw different streamers have different background sounds. There are birds in a garden stream. Oh yeah, I always get sirens. I wish I got the birds. I got the sirens. Actually, Sometimes I get a pigeon coming into the kitchen. I don't know where they are. They must be like in the walls somewhere above me. But sometimes I hear pigeons cooing in the other room. It's kind of interesting. I'm like, oh, it's the pigeons. There's some whose background sounds like a racetrack. Oh no. Oh no. Was near a hospital. There are a lot of ambulances that go by here. That seems to be the way. Maybe there's just more danger here. Have you thought about that? No, that's not really the case. Vienna's a really safe city. I really like how chill it is. There wants to sound like their neighbors at the airport. Oh, that's awful. No. More danger in front of your house does make a lot of sense. Yeah. It's like a Denny's parking lot out there. Da-da. And there's also motorcyclists, apparently. And I got hit by a bus this week. No, Giant! How dare you? What the heck was that about?
There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor boy. In God, I know I'm one. My mother was a tailor. She sewed my new blue jeans. My father was a gambling man down in New Orleans. Now the only thing a gambler needs is a suitcase and a truck, and the only time he's satisfied is when he's on a truck. Oh, mother, tell your children not to do what I have done. Spend your life in sin and misery in the house of the rising sun. There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor boy. And God, I know I'm one.
Let me see this. I was on my bike commuting home and had to cross a bus line. I did look right for buses, then a car almost cut me off and I forgot to look left. Oh no. Oh, that's so freaky. I was thinking you were a pedestrian, so I was like, how did the bus almost hit you when you were walking? But if you're biking, that stuff's sketchy. Yeah, electric buses are super quiet. The car driver has 77 people to answer. Why 77? And we'll send you the medieval version of that song. Please do. Please do. I love Hildegard von Bingen. Oh, Rolling in the Deep. Oh no, this is going to be a little tricky, I think. We'll give it a try. 77 kneecaps, because that's one person each. Is that? Oh, that's how many people are watching. Okay. I'm gonna put that away. That's too many people. Y'all gotta go. I ride a bike everywhere and I've never been hit by a car. I always make sure to hit first. Man, that's... No, I don't think that's how that works. No, please don't leave. No, I need you. Dex, come back. Yeah. Eggy, welcome on in. You always hit first. Do you have like a... I was imagining you with like a medieval javelin. What are they called? Where you're like riding the horse and they have the spear. You're like, gonna hit the car first.
A fever pitch and it's bringing me out the dark.
I don't know what key I want to sing this on.
Deep side of your hand and you played it to the beat.
We'll try this key. We'll be okay.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out and I'll lay your ship bare. See how I leave with every piece of you. Don't underestimate the things that I will do. There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch and it's bringing me out the dark. The scars of your love remind me of us. They keep me thinking that we almost had it all. The scars of your love, they leave me breathless. I can't help feeling we could have had it all. Rolling in the deep, scars of your love remind me of us. I keep me thinking that we almost had it all. The scars of your love, they leave me breathless. I can't help feeling we could have had it all. Blessings to find what you look for. Turn my sorrow into treasure gold. You'll pay me back in kind and reap just what you sowed. We could have had it all, rolling in the deep.
Those chords, they didn't give me anything for the bridge. What happens to the bridge? They say no chords available. I think there should be a chord there. Stoic Passion, thank you so much for continuing your sub. Welcome on in. Happy Saturday. And CC, welcome on in. Hello, hello. You burned the bridge. We burned the bridge. We got John burned that bridge. Well, that wasn't too bad. I could probably take it up a bit next time, but I just really don't want to play it in G sharp minor. Oh, it got toxic? This is fun. Da 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 da.
Baby, can't you see I'm calling? A guy like you should wear a warning. It's dangerous and I'm falling. There's no escape, I can't wait. I need a hit, baby, give me it. You're dangerous and I'm loving it. Too high, can't come down. Losing my head, spinning round and round. Do you feel me now? Taste of your lips, I'm on a ride. You're toxic, I'm slipping under with the taste of your poison. Paradise, I'm addicted to you. Now that you're toxic, yeah, I love what you do. Don't you know that you're toxic? It's getting late to give you up. I took a sip from my devil's cup. Slowly it's taking over me. Too high, can't come down. Losing my head, spinning round and round. Do you feel me now? Taste of your lips, I'm on a ride. You're toxic, I'm slipping under with the taste of your poison. Paradise, I'm addicted to you. Don't you know that you're toxic? Yeah, I love what you do. Don't you know that you're toxic? Yeah, I love what you do. Don't you know that you're toxic?
Yeah, that was fun. Bow, 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 bow. Oh my god, my choice? Oh no. What should my choice be? Da, 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 da. It's my favorite way to say no, the Australian way.
For an easy thing. Oh, no.
You imagine doing that with a black horse and a cherry tree? Nar, 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 nar. Oh, nar. I really want to do that now. Dang, I had the name of it and I lost it. So that's your choice? No. Seemed like you're gonna sing No Roots. No Roots, cause my home was never on the ground. Oh my gosh, what's it called? What's it called? There's two chords, nothing but thieves.
If I get high enough, will I see you again?
I think that's what I'm gonna do.
If I get high enough, run and we run and we run and we run and we run until we break through. If I get high enough, if I get high enough, will I see you again? Will I see you again? If I get high, if I get high, if I get high. And we run 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 until we break through. And we run 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 and we run.
I used to have like a cool chord progression on this one, because I know it's just these two, but I used to have like a, I don't know, something different. I love the emo tab for that one. That one always reminds me of Paul too. The song Paul by Big Thief. Da, 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 da. Teddy Photos, thank you very much for the follow. And Juan, too, hopefully I said that right. Thank you for the follow as well. I see we have the full version of Viva La Vida. Oh my gosh, don't remember the last time that happened. I build a wall. I build a wall. Oh. You build a wall. Oh, I think I play it quite a bit higher up. You build a wall. Yeah. Yeah. Oh. Well, sorry, I'm like trying to read the tab riff, but I suck at reading tab. Okay, it's all 1 and 3, it's all 1 3. Alright, we'll just work with it. Works so well with the mood of the game. Yeah, it's a really cool song. Oh, but it's not gonna work. That riff isn't gonna work in the key that I have it in.
Dig my hole, you built a wall. I dig my hole, you built a wall. One day that wall is gonna fall. Gonna build that city on a hill. Gonna build that city on a hill. Someday those tears are gonna spill. So build that wall and build it strong, 'cause we build that wall up to the sky. Gonna build that wall up to the sky. Someday your bird is gonna fly. Gonna build that wall until it's done. Gonna build that wall until it's done. But now you've got nowhere to run. So build that wall and build it strong, 'cause we'll be there before too long.
Then it goes into whatever that other cool song is.
The wind, it will take me.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool song.
Except she requested a musical song.
That song is cool too. Yeah, it's a really cool set, cool song. I have the game that goes with. I don't remember what game it's called. Something with an A? But, Bastion, that's what it is. Really fun. I'll see if I can learn the riff. it's one thing to learn the riff, and then another thing to sing while playing the riff. But I guess it matches the melody, so that's not too bad then. Yeah.
What's it called? There's a fine line.
I'm not gonna play the F that happens at the end of the bridge because it just totally messes me up. Play the riff first and then sing over it. That is a fabulous idea. That is a fabulous idea. I know, I was thinking about loop pedal. I really gotta figure out how to loop. All the cool kids are doing it. And I wanna be a cool kid. Kid, but if you're not looping, then turns out it's wrong. I know, I'm not a cool kid. Only the cool kids loop. I haven't figured out how to be cool like them yet. You guys see that? Hold on. There's this meme. If I can find it, I'll post it in the meme channel on the Discord. But it's like a deep sea scuba diver with like the old style metal helmet on. And he's like, man, the pressure down here is insane. It's crazy. And then this fish goes up to him and he's like, all the cool kids are doing drugs. And he's like, all the cool kids, you say? The pressure is so severe. All the cool kids, you say? And I just think about that. Like, all the cool kids are looping. All the cool kids, you say? Well. I do really like the live singing and playing without looping too. Maybe even more than looping. The only problem I have with looping, which I wouldn't do if I were to add looping eventually on the set, I just reminded that my light's very white and it's bothering me. I'm like, oh, just a little more yellow. Look, oh, that's better. Okay. Is when it takes like 20 minutes to build a whole song. So it's like the song itself is 4 minutes long, but it takes like 10 to 15 minutes just to build up to the point where they can sing the song. I'm like, it's just too long. It's too long. So I would definitely have like just like a backing track or something that I could pull from. I just like a beat, some kind of beats that I could use. And maybe just something that, I don't know, something that adds a little bit of depth to the song, but I wouldn't do like a full musical textural scape, probably. I would do baby looping. Well, looping, I think it's a cool thing. And like, I'd like to be able to add looping to my live shows as well, like at gigs and stuff for the restaurant. I think it'd just be really neat. And just a little bit more than me and the guitar, so.
There's a fine line between a lover and a friend. And there's a fine, fine line between reality and pretend. And you never know till you reach the top if it was worth the uphill climb. There's a fine, fine line between love and a waste of time. And there's a fine, fine line between a fairy tale and a lie. And there's a fine, fine line between your wonderful and goodbye. I guess if someone doesn't love you back, it isn't such a crime. But there's a fine, fine line between love and a waste of your time. And I don't have the time to waste on you anymore. There's a fine, fine line between together and not. And there's a fine, fine line between what you wanted and what you got. You've gotta go after the things you want while you're still in your prime. There's a
with the have I found my chord. No. I do like the live singing and playing without looping too. Oh, I already did that. It has to fit the vibe for sure. I like people who can play the looper like an instrument, adding a few layers to part of the song so it's not really obvious that you're looping until you wonder why it sounds so full from only a single musician. Yeah, exactly. I think like a little goes a long way with looping. I think if you have something, yeah, that just kind of like fleshes out the song a bit. And you're not trying to like build everything on top of it. I mean, people do, and they're incredible. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, full-on looping people are fantastic and really cool, and I would not be able to do it very well. It's just how personally at the pace of the stream, that's how I would like to use it so that we keep like a decent pace. You know, it doesn't take too long to do a whole bunch of songs. ABC man, welcome on in. Good morning to you. There are a couple streamers who do take a very long time and many layers to complete a song. Yeah, and then it's like, it's cool, and it's super cool when you get down to it, but it's, active looping is nice, like looping while playing. Yeah, looping while playing is really cool, yeah. As well, like, this is kind of a dumb thing that happens, but when you're like me and you can taste sound, it gets really gross really fast, because when you're listening to the same chord progression, and instead of hearing it for the 4 minutes that's in the song, you hear it for an additional like 7 minutes while they're building the song, then it's like, sometimes it gives me, it just is not good. Like, I get like physically kind of sick of the song before they get to singing, which sucks, because like when they start singing, I'm like, oh yeah, this is really good, but I've already heard the loop progression so many times that sometimes it gives me some sensory overload, I guess is the best way to describe it. What happens if you're eating and tasting songs at the same time? the taste of the food will override the taste of the song. That's super awkward. Waiting for, yeah, and then if there's a mistake and stuff. And knowing me, I make all kinds of mistakes all the time, every single day. So I just have to use it sparingly, I think, would be the good thing. But I still think it's a good tool to add to the channel. I think it'd be really nice. And it would let me play two instruments. So like if I can loop something on the piano and then I can play something on guitar, then we got like a cool vibe going on, right? hilarious hearing that go a long way.
Yeah.
The food is maple syrup.
My gosh darn, love maple syrup, bud.
Maybe keep it to one or two songs on the list. Not sure what the best approach would be. Yeah, and I mean, some songs lend themselves more to looping than others. Like, immediately I think of Aurora's Runaway, because she has all these really beautiful chords in there, or like harmonies. And but there's some songs that wouldn't translate very well. Like, there's no way I'd be able to loop at Denny's unless I'm putting like a drum backing track on it or something. Which song tastes like maple syrup? I don't know. There's songs that taste sweet, but there's no song that I can recall being like, oh yeah, that's maple syrup. A bunch of pop songs that are just four chords. Yeah. Yeah, that's true. It depends, like, if there's a pre-chorus or something. I have to be... Or, like, the song that I did, If I Get High by Nothing But Thieves. They're only two chords. You could do, like, a lot of looping possibilities with that, because it's the one and the five, so they're also quite malleable. I write a song that tastes like maple syrup. I don't write songs by taste normally. I write the lyrics by taste sometimes, because you want it to be fun. Very Canadian of you. Canadian song. Normally. Oh, this is the one that had the weird chord progression last time. Get this going. Safe and sound. Let me look up all the versions that they have of this song. No, Denny's. I don't know. It's kind of basic, honestly. Denny's isn't very exciting to taste. But could you do that? I guess. I don't see why not. I don't normally like pay attention to taste with writing songs unless it's bad. Like, unless it tastes bad, and then you're like, oh, I should probably fix that. Otherwise, it's like, I don't try for a specific taste. It's just like, is what it is. Imagine making these super weird lyrics nobody understands just by writing songs by taste. I used to do that with my poetry. It would drive everyone crazy. There's an artist. Oh my god, what's her name? She does... I miss sugar pink, lick a lick of lips. Hit me with your sweet love, steal me with a kiss. Miss sugar pink. What's her name? Oh my gosh. Marina and the Diamonds. Apparently she has synesthesia as well with the taste. And she like does her lyrics accordingly, which is wild because I always found her lyrics very tasty, like really good before I even knew. Someone was like, oh yeah, no, she has that as well. I'm like, oh my god, that makes so much sense, because there's some lines in there where you're just like, whoa. Yeah, I was told that she does. Maybe I was lied to, I don't know. But it definitely makes sense because her lyrics are like really, really wild. And they taste really good often. Look in the wall of a Denny's. Mogo, thank you so much for the raid. Welcome on in. Mogo, please feel free to check out the song list if you would like. Love me some Marina. Yeah, Marina's awesome. I haven't heard any of her new stuff. I really love her old stuff. From Greece. Oh my gosh. Welcome on in. Lyrics taste very good. Isn't even the weirdest sentence we've heard on this stream. Yeah. Yeah, you're right, probably. You're right. I'm sure it's very confusing for the new people coming in, but you know, for the regular crowd, it's nothing new. Yeah, and normally, like, when I'm listening to a song and I'm tasting the song, it's more lyric-focused. The lyrics are stronger than the music, normally. I'm so not happy with these chords. They just make me sad. Definitely sounded weird to me. Dasbury, you're new here. You'll learn. Does it work the other way around too? You eat food and lyrics come to mind? No. No. I don't know how to like describe that. It's so funny. I've never heard anything weird here. Never heard anything weird before. Alright, we're gonna work with these chords and we'll just hope that I can maybe adjust my voice to these chords or vice versa.
I remember tears streaming down your face when I said I'd never let you go. And all those shadows almost killed your light. I remember you said, don't leave me here alone. But all that static gone and passed tonight. Just close your eyes. The sun is going down. You'll be alright. No one can hurt you now. Come morning light, you and I'll be safe and sound. Don't you dare look out your window, darling, everything's on fire. The war outside our door keeps raging on. And hold on to this lullaby, even when the music's gone. Just close your eyes. The sun is going down. You'll be alright. No one can hurt you now. Come morning light, you and I'll be safe and sound.
That song annoys me so much. Why does it not work? It's gotta be me. It gotta be that I'm not singing it right, but I swear that's how it goes. And the F and the D minor mess me up so much. Max Roberts, welcome on in! Happy Saturday. Annoying song. I used to sing it like with the guitar, it was never a problem. That's why I like threw it on the list. I'm like, oh yeah, I know this song, this is fine. And I don't know why recently, I have to listen to it again. I think I just have to listen to it again. And then I'll know where I'm going wrong with it. I think your singing is fine as the chords. Yeah, it's just you wanna. I've been subbing in the D minor because it's like, just
sun is going down.
Like, there's just no reason that should be an F.
You'll be alright. No one can hurt you now.
It just gotta go. And that's weird because those are like the official chords, like the, you know, ultimate guitar approved chords. And I think they're lying to me.
I used to rule the world. Seas would rise when I gave the word. Now in the morning I sleep alone. Sweep the streets I used to own. To roll the dice, feel the fear in my enemy's eyes, listen as the crowd would sing. Missionary. the world.
Hearing the whole thing. Yeah, it feels weird singing the whole thing. It's true. Teddy Photos, thank you so much for the compliment. I'll certainly take a compliment from me. That is actually a compliment to you. Thank you for choosing this stream to join today. And you have fantastic hair energy, which means that if you have fantastic hair if you have hair, and if you don't have hair, you have fantastic hair energy. Got the vibes. I know, the song feels so long in comparison to the abridged version. Ta-da. It's labeled as a work in progress. Oh, the Taylor Swift song. So goofy. So goofy, that one. I'm just here for Earl. That's the man. That's the man. We have a channel point redemption. We can bring him up front now for a song. Well, a piano song. I don't think he's going to fit on my lap if I'm playing the guitar. Sister. No Denny song today? I'm sorry, Cedric, we did it right off the bat. We started with a lot of the originals of today. Bow, 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 bow. He does not fit inside the guitar, unfortunately.
Well, I tried to make it Sunday, but I got so damn depressed that I set my sights on Monday and I got myself undressed. I ain't ready for the altar, but I do agree there's time where a woman sure can be a friend of mine. Well, I keep on thinking about you, sister, golden-haired surprise. And I just can't live without you. Can't you see it in my eyes? I've been one poor correspondent. I've been too hard to find. But that doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. And will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me in the air? Will you love me just a little? Just enough to show you care? Well, I tried to fake it. I don't mind saying I just can't make it. I keep on thinking about you, sister, golden hair surprise. And I just can't live without you. Can't you see it in my eyes? I've been one poor correspondent. I've been too hard to find. But that doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. And will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me in the air? Will you love me just a little? Just enough to show you care? Well, I tried to fake it. I don't mind saying I just can't make it.
Well, California dreaming. Digging the song. You got two good song choices there, bud.
Just can't live without you.
I didn't wake up in time for the Denny song. No, we don't normally play it that early in the stream. I'm sorry.
Hushabye mountain. Hushabye mountain.
How are you with the time and the song cue? Oh, that's a good question. One, two. I mean, Lord doesn't really count because it's your bridge version. Three, four. No, we should be fine. We should be fine to do all of them today. Do it. I'm energized. I'm caffeinated. Let's go. Oh, we could do the last two slots if you want as well. Dex, you can put the last two songs available. I don't mind. Yeah. Yeah, because Lord doesn't count. It's like super small. We don't ask that if Live Plays for 24 hours, that is good. Nah!
A gentle breeze from Hushabye Mountain softly blows o'er Lullaby Bay. It fills the sails of boats that are waiting to sail your worries away. It isn't far to Hushabye Mountain, and your boat waits down. Night so softly are sighing, soon they will fly your troubles to sea. So close your eyes on Hushabye Mountain, wave goodbye to cares of the day. Watch your boat from Hushabye Mountain sail far away from Lullaby Bay. Sail far away from Lullaby Bay.
Did it. Especially the streamer. I'm not here to be responsible. Absolutely not. So soothing. Yeah! I love that song. Especially when it goes into key change. Adult supervision for a reason. That's why he helps me run the stream.
Mr. Earl. Dun, dun, dun. I gotta get this one. Wait, abridged?
Yeah, okay. Hold on. I really had to use my brain on that for a second.
Ba-ba. And everybody's like fancy stuff and valuable things and blah blah blah, excessive spending, but we don't care. We're from a shitty town and we're poor.
Royals abridged. Beautiful. A beautiful masterpiece of a condensed version. We got a Northern Downpour, yeah. Are we ending? Oh, I was like, there's no way they're gonna let me end on my choice. The final note cracks me up every time. Yes. Lyricism. Isn't it great? And we're poor. Like, yeah, you wish, Zepsi. Why is... Oh my god, my dapper pedal squeaking again. I have drowned this thing in WD-40. It's not having it. Or is it the chair? Hold on. If it's the chair, that's an easy fix. Is it the stand? I'm so confused. It's not the chair. Is it the piano stand? No. What is making that sound? It's gone now. It's gone, I don't know. It's my knees. Everyone can hear Zepsi's knees from here. Earl is singing the song of his people.
If all our life is but a dream, fantastic posing greed that we should feed our jewelry to the
Zip ties, Zepsi. Have you tried zip ties, Zepsi? Zip ties, maybe. Clean and simple. Yeah, it's a great song. Crazy lyrics. Drac is in the chat. Hello, Mr. Drac. Happy Saturday to you. Oh, Don't Feel Good Ink. Oh my gosh. I don't know how the rest of the song goes. I never know how the rest of the song goes. I know you guys want me to like keep the stream going forever, but you know that the sooner I get off here, the sooner we can play video games together, right? Just letting you know. It's not like I'm going away, I'm coming right back. Echo Isn't Just Brandon? Yeah, this song... There's not... Okay, Panic at the Disco has some really tasty songs. They have like this... They have some songs like She Had the World. It's this like sherbet yellow pink, and it's sweet and a little bit sour, and it's just delicious. Hayaro time. GDG's over here like, come on, when can I host Lethal Company? I know. Well, I know I was a little under time on Wednesday. Well, not under time, because I do say that the stream's only going to be 2 hours, but we always end up doing three. But I know that most people expect normal 3 hours. But Wednesdays, I don't normally have enough energy, whereas Saturdays, I you know, it's later in the day. I've gotten more done. I don't feel stressed. I don't mind doing a little longer. I'm at a railway station. No, Drac! We're going to play Lethal Company tonight. If you get back in time, you should join us. It'll be like an hour or two after stream, because I need food and stuff. I'll probably order in today, actually. I don't know what I'm going to do. And I'll join the video game so you can keep the stream going. Just Giant's over here like, no. Giant, join us. It's super fun. I scream a lot. Charlie and Dex are like just completely stone-faced, super cool. They go in, they get all the loot, and I'm over here like, ah, loot bugs. That's a fun part. You don't have the game? It's not that expensive. I think it's like $10 or something. I think. I don't remember. She also curses in Discord. That's true. Yeah, if stuff is scary, I will swear. So if you all want to watch that. What games are we talking about? We're playing Lethal Company, which has been super, super fun. I'm hours away. Still coming back from National Park. Oh, well, National Park is lovely. That's nice. Well, you'll have to catch us next weekend then, because we'll probably do it next weekend as well. And do all scary games. Yeah, very dangerous. My friend and I made so much progress when it was just the two of us. We were able to afford like a $600 moon. So we went, and it was the one that had a girl that goes, like, is haunts one member of the crew. And we've never run into this enemy before. So I'm like, oh, this is a nice place. And Lazo's freaking out. And I'm like, I don't understand what you're talking about. There's no one there. And she's like, there's someone there. There's someone there. What a terrifying monster to have. Expensive. I know. And we didn't get like barely, we got like two kettles out of the run. It was totally not worth it. But we made like $500 more on a run. Like we totally raked in on one level. So we were able to afford a moon. And then it wasn't worth it. Have you seen her? I haven't. We looked at the wiki after. She looks very scary. I think Lappy's Chaos would fare well in Overcooked. Oh my god, my friend and I play Overcooked. I suck at it. I suck at it so much. But my friend's really good, so we make it work. Did you get a ship horn? I did. I also got a ship horn. And my friend was like, why'd you get this? I'm like, just wait and see. And then later on, she's like using it constantly. It's really fun. Yeah, we did so well. And then on the next round, we didn't even clock like 200. So we definitely got fired. But it was such a good run for like two rounds. Yeah, Overcooked played up. And there's another one. I don't know. My two friends are super structured and the one friend who would bring the chaos. Oh no. That's amazing. I've only ever played it with one other person, so I've only ever done a duo. That's the best group to play any co-op game, to be honest. There's another co-op game, I was trying to think of what... We did Stardew Valley for a little bit, and... Oh my gosh, I can't think of it. I wonder what you'd be like in Deep Rock Galactic. Oh yeah, I looked it up, by the way, because I wasn't sure. It looks cool, but I'm not like super fond of the... like League of Legends style where you're kind of in third person. I kind of prefer first person games, but the graphics look really cool. I'm down to check it out. definitely fun mixing pros with noobs. Yes, and chaotic players, yes. Doesn't count as cozy when you poison the village. I just find joy in tormenting the people of the village, and that has nothing to do with being a goose. I just really enjoy upsetting everyone in Stardew Valley. Hey, look, a song.
City's breaking down on a camel's back. They just have to go
through fire.
Just have to go, cause they don't know why. And now you fill the streets, it's appealing to see. Cause you won't get out of the country, cause you're damned and free. You've got a new horizon, it's inferior style. A melancholy town where you never smile. And all I wanna hear is the message beep. My dreams, they've got a kiss because I don't get sleep, no. Windmill, windmill for the land. Turn forever hand in hand. Take it all and in your stride. It is sinking, falling down. Love forever, love is free. Let's turn forever, you and me. Windmill, windmill for the land. Is everybody in?
And then I don't know what happens with that song. That's why it has a wrench on it.
Laughing gas. There's ponies on the track. It's my chocolate stack.
I don't know how it goes.
Cause don't stop, get it, until you jet ahead. You're washed the way I navigate.
I don't know.
Windmill, windmill for the land. Turn forever hand in hand. Take it all in your stride. It is sinking, falling down. Love forever, love is free. Let's turn.
To find some better way to do this. What's on? Deep Rock Galactica's first person? Oh, maybe I was looking up Helldivers. Gotcha. A ranch simulator. I put my chickens on top of the wooden crate because they won't wander off. Oh, that's nice. They did fall off the crate overnight. I would have walked all over the game world. Oh no, your chickens. Maidenless, you have redeemed a username color. Oh, what did I do? Maidenless, this is where I tell you what your username is to me as someone with synesthesia, so I can taste and see color with written words and music. So for you, Maidenless is pink because of the M, which is the only letter in my alphabet that is pink, and then a little bit red from the A. So maiden, you have like a pink red beginning and then a brown green ending, a Maidenless. And then Liss is green and yellow. Yeah, color combo. Maidenless. But you have an H in there, which makes it more brown. If you had maiden without the H, it wouldn't be as brown. Now you know. Da, 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 da. It's kind of silly, I guess, like username color. I should put it username colors because no one is really like one specific color. It's always like a little mix. What was the color of my name since I changed it? Jar is interesting because it's like kind of green and red, but it tastes really good. Jar is a good tasting word. And then because you're Charlie with an I, you have like, you're still like a brighter yellow white type of Charlie, and you don't have an E in there. So it's just a little more red because your Charlie, which ends with white in, it starts with white, it goes to blue a little bit, and then A is red, and then Jar has a bit of red in it as well. The Google logo, that's a toddler learning to mix paint colors. Yeah, I never said they were coherent or good chords. Or chords, colors. apparently the synapses are like the connections are made very, very early on in childhood. So I'm sure in my brain is like just toddler colors, because when you're a kid, that's how they, you know, how you do. Zed Life, hey, welcome on in. I play a bit of piano, guitar, lovely. My friend has synesthesia and she made me picture all the colors she saw when she heard my favorite song, Landslide, with Fleetwood Mac. Oh my gosh, that'd be so pretty. Oh, that's so nice. Landslide. Landslide, bring you down. I don't know why, but that one's kind of like oaky tasting. It has a very unique taste, and I can't figure out if it's a chord progression or not. It must be really pretty. That's the cool thing about people with synesthesia as well, like a different color palette. So what your friend sees is probably like really different from what I see. I never heard a streamer say that someone in chat tastes very good. No, Charlie. It's just the C. Maiden, no. Maiden, yes. Oh my gosh. Which one are we talking about? The newer case? What case? What case where? Hold on, I gotta sing a song. I gotta sing a song so I can order dinner and then we can play video games. Hold on. What do I wanna play? Oh, beer case. Yeah, of course. We're here for songs? I know, don't tell anybody. Don't tell anyone we're here for songs. Did somebody put that in the lamp out of context? Something that tastes like you have to do it. I don't know. It's always a surprise whenever I go into the lamp out of context. I'm like, what's happening over here now? You eat songs for dinner? I don't know. My mouth says yes, but the rest of my digestive system is like, there's nothing here. It's like the LaCroix, right? It's like a LaCroix. It just tastes like things, but there's nothing actually there. And sometimes it's not even a taste. Sometimes it's a texture. Like, I say taste, but sometimes there's a taste and a texture. Sometimes it's just texture. Something will taste like fuzzy, like Pop Rocks, or crunchy, or, you know, that kind of thing. Lit the candles one by one. Oh, we can do this one, I guess. My piano glitching out. I heard like a thing. Songs of sustenance, yes. I was following the pack, all swallowed in the coats, with scarves of red tied round their throats to keep their little heads from falling in the snow. And I turned around and there you go, and Michael, you'd fall. Turn the white snow red as strawberries in the summertime. Yeah, I haven't heard it do that before. My gear always likes to surprise me with new glitches. Oh, Zed Life, thank you for the follow as well. And we shall end it on the ending song. And then we will give Mr. Upstairs some peace. I don't know, Zed, see if you can't stop me. Maybe if I get a loop pedal one day, I'll add some piano with it and have a duel. That'd be cool, actually. Lately, it's been hard getting out of my shelter. Misfortune's whispering. Yeah, I have found. I'll still mess up a bit for you.
In the stars, I am a lion, but lately I am something else. In these shadows on the wall, I can't recognize myself. At least tomorrow's another day. A fresh start, a few hours away. And I'll be better, I'll be braver. I will be my own savior. Just give me a little time till then. I swear in the past, I handled it better. And maybe I was kinder when things passed me by. Well, I should be out there trying, but I wanna stay inside. For this evening I am tired, overworked, unqualified. At least tomorrow's another day. A fresh start, a few hours away. And I'll be better, I'll be braver. I will be my own savior. Just give me a little time till then. And let me hide and decompose inside the petals of my mind. And I will find all the answers to the storms in my life. And I'll be better, I'll be braver. I will be my own savior. Just give me a little time till then.
Dermo and Diego. I don't know if I said hi to you guys yet. Hello. Hello. Yeah. Yeah. So when you play Shelter. Sebsi, I don't know what you're talking about. Atomic, hey, I caught your stream, one of my favorite songs, no less. I'm so glad to hear it. I'm sorry you caught us just at the end here. Yeah. Aw, I'm glad you guys like my songs. I gotta write some new songs, though. They're in the process. I have a couple. I have, Midas, I can certainly add the acoustic version to the list, but, I have a song called Balloons, which is like a cute little thing, and I have, I don't know, there's like another one, but we'll see. I gotta do some writing. I haven't really been composing a whole lot lately. I've been doing a lot of just like musician performer stuff. My teacher's like, what have you done? A lot, but not new stuff. Telephone. I wish I could do Telephone. That's going to be the one that I'll probably release with my voice teacher singing it, because she has way better pipes for that song than me. Take my heart through the telephone. I can hear you talking even when I'm alone. I might be able to transpose it, maybe. Take my call, baby, one more time. I need you to go, but can you stay on the line? But then it's really low in the verses is the problem. I don't know why I wrote it like that. It's goofy, really. I don't remember the chords for it either. Do I have the lead sheet to that? Just where we're finding, when, while we're finding somewhere to raid, I'm just gonna see if I have lead sheet for Telephone. I have the score. Oh my god, this fruit fly, get out of here. I got like one of those little fruit fly traps, and they don't, it means nothing to them. They don't care at all, and it makes me very sad. I should check if the Lamplighters accept PayPal yet. Oh, I wish they would. I don't know why they don't. Where's the gosh darn wood? Imagine having lychee for a song but not aviator rigged.
Yeah, I've punched in. Can you hear me?
Oh man, it's been a long time since I played this song.
Man, I've punched in. Can you hear me? Hello, I've got a bone to pick through this telephone. Thought I'd write you a letter. Keep it old-fashioned and sweet. Keep it old-fashioned and sweet. But when it's time for yelling, a phone call can't be beat.
So not in the right key for my voice.
Take my call, baby, one more time. I need you to go, but can you stay on the line?
Wow. Yeah, this thing. Romeo and Juliet type musical over your songs. That'd be fun. That'd be fun and cool. The bridge is fun, though.
You say the connection's bad, I cannot help but agree. Maybe I'll just hang up here and find somewhere else to be. Your smothering was divine, but you have kept me in line. I think I'll buy my freedom, buy my freedom now before I run out of dimes.
And the ending is really fun because it's like a
da 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 da.
I don't know. But yeah, I want to give it to a rock band because it should be more of a rock song, really.
We taking Shakespeare or Dire Straits? Ooh, Dire Straits is very nice, though.
All right, who's live? I'm gonna go get dinner.
Dang. Venus World has, she says, album release. I don't know her, but
I'm sure Mr. Upstairs is going to be very happy when I stop singing. Zoe. We go see Zoe. I haven't seen Zoe in a while, and we haven't visited Zoe in a while, actually. Cooking stream.
We'd had a suggestion? Who? Nicole is also live. New to you. Oh, new to me. Well, let's go in. I like seeing new people.
We should all come and visit Vienna one day and have a stern talk with Mr. Upstairs. I'm like, it's a beautiful day out. It's Saturday. He's always home. He's always home all the time. Every single day of the week, he's home. I know he works from home, but like, just, I don't understand. How many crowbars do we need? No crowbars. I don't want to get arrested in this country. I have a clean record. But surely fun.
We're
meet at Denny's. So funny. Yes. Oh no. How many crowbars? Yes.
See, I'll see you in Discord later.
Where are we going? You said you had a new one. Let's go somewhere new. If not, we should go see Zoe, because it's been a while.
Through the telephone, I can hear you talking.
Oh, my own song stuck in my head. Brr. Banana Music? Is that what they're called?
Banana _ Music?
Oh, sorry, I missed that. Dang. My bad.
Oh, Deutsch.
Deutsch. Let's do it. It's always visiting TwitchCon. Yeah. German and English. Lieben, wir sind nur Lisa. Musik ist unsere Leidenschaft und diese wollen wir mit euch teilen. Cool. Let's do it. Man, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me this Saturday. Such a good time. And what do I have? Do I have any exciting stuff to say? Not really. There's going to be some behind-the-scenes stuff in the members' channel coming soon. So if you want to see some music videos before they're released, that's where they'll be. Yeah, you guys are fantastic. Thank you just so much for coming in every stream. It's so wild to see that so many people like hanging out here with us. And I love having you guys around. So yeah, if you want to play Lethal Company, we're doing that tonight. I don't think she'll be this year. She's in Hawaii. Oh, dang. Oh, everyone, please copy the raid. Copy the raid command. I'm going to do that as well. For Travel Company, a pleasure, sir. A pleasure. Yeah. And hopefully we're going to get some good stuff released. Oh, sorry. Let me put on the end scene here before we go. Bye, everybody.